It has been business as usual in the House this week as the Budget Committee members had to burn night candles to prepare the final report of the 2023-2024 financial year budget.
To the UGANDA for the draft budget estimates for the financial year 2023-2024, I beg to lay.
UGANDA after another to the budget gave the House tough time to process the budget, and the Ministry of Finance had its share of swipes on Tuesday when they threw in an addendum to the UGANDA on the 11th hour, amounting to 817 billion shillings, that revised the budget upwards to 52.7 trillion.
There's 50 trillion, it became 51, it is now 52. And the Budget Committee was given 2 hours to scrutinize, because the law says you scrutinize 800 billion shilling. Even if you are angels, there is no way you're going to scrutinize 8 billion shilling in 2 hours. So this delay by the committee has been occasioned by a government that wants to act in darkness. So they want to throw huge figures at MPs because they know they will not read. And then you come carrying them on your head. No, you can't do that.
His documents are increasingly unreliable and incomplete. Will he lay a statement attesting to their reliability? Because incompetence and unreliability is now becoming an art form of sorts.
After a long budgeting process that started in December when the Minister of Finance laid the budget framework paper, the House was able to pass the revised budget of 2023-2024 financial year in a sitting, which started at 8 a.m. and ended at 5 p.m.
Every district should be given 1 billion shillings straight to the local government. Yeah. The problem, most of you don't come to the House. The resolution, the money for the rural road fund is intact.
Economic growth this financial year is projected at 5.5%, up from 4.7% in 21-22.
The budget was passed amid resistance from the opposition's minority report, which was suggesting huge budget cuts on the State House budget on grounds that allocations are not in line with the Presidential Emoluments and Benefits Act.
Domestic resources, 33.341 trillion. Budget support, Uganda shillings, 2.781 trillion. Project support, Uganda shillings, 8.25 trillion.
Our resolution that on top of that, each district gets an additional 1 billion going forward annually for road maintenance.
But the road fund has been one thing that is helping us hold on to some of our roads which are not tarmacked in most of the districts upcountry. This is totally unacceptable.
There were key observations that the total public debt stock, which the Bank of UGANDA report quotes at 86 trillion shillings, is soon becoming unsustainable, while the budget itself is not aligned to the National Development Plan 3.
UGANDA's external debt is largely concessional. That is a cheaper debt as of now. It's about 75%. The share of non-concessional debt is on the rise. That means the lenders are tightening the lending policies and reviewing terms. So if we are to borrow now, we are most likely going to borrow at a very high interest rate. And that will raise our interest. And we have to be very cautious as a country to maintain a favorable debt interest.
The government said they will borrow 8.4 trillion. Now they come with a figure they are going to borrow 10. For external, they committed to borrow 10. For domestic, they've gone ahead and borrowed 11.
In the same week, the House passed the Traffic and Road Safety Bill 2023 with a fine of 2 million shillings for offenders of speed limits on the road.
I now put a question that the Traffic and Road Safety Amendment Bill 2023 be read for the second time. Those in favor say on the contrary, nay. The ayes have it.
Under the Traffic and Road Safety Act, violation attracts a sentence of a fine of 200,000 shillings. Here now they are proposing 20 million. 20 million. So when it comes now to enforcement, if you give two alternatives under different laws, then you will not be achieving the purpose.
Parliament also received the annual report on the state of human rights and freedom from the Uganda Human Rights Commission, highlighting Pentecostal churches among the leading violators of human rights by manipulating and exploiting followers.
There's extortion and corruption, and this is not done by one sect, but it is more prominent in the Pentecostal churches because they do not have structures that govern them.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.